Everybody, this is Bonnie, and I'm coming to you with week number 2 of the scrapbooking challenge. I'm very excited about this. I don't know, I haven't checked my email yet to see if anybody's followed along with me, but I hope I have lots of emails in there on Friday with people that by midnight, or Sunday by midnight, with people that have done their pages. So this is going to be pertaining to the layout that I posted on the blog, and this is what I'm going to do. This is a two-page spread. We're going to start with page 1. I've decided that I want to use cherry cobbler as my base, so this is 12 by 12 cherry cobbler, and then I am using some designer series paper. This is soft suede designer series paper. This paper is retired. I'm going to place this kind of right about here. I think that looks good. Then the next thing I did was I ended up having to map my pictures that I had going vertical other than the way that the photo had you have them going this way. So I just switched mine up a little bit. So I've got some soft suede and some bubblegum, bubblegum green. Or gumball green, new in color. I absolutely love it. So let's adhere this down. Go right there. Now I've gone ahead and I've punched out the words apple. These photos are of my daughter making apple pie with grandma on Thanksgiving for the first time. She was finally old enough to help grandma do the apple pie, so she was very, very excited. All the other kids have had chances, so now it was her turn. And I've made these little apples, and I just want to show you quick how I made the apples. First thing I did was I punched it out with just the regular large heart punch. Then I took a pair of scissors and I just kind of made like a wave effect, so it looked like the base of an apple. So it looks like that. Then I sponged the top of it with cherry cobbler, and then I just sponged the bottom of it with the bubblegum green. And then I went ahead and I punched out the bird punch. I used the tray trim here, the leaf, and I punched it out in black. And then I also punched it out in the bubblegum green so that I could get a leaf on it. And then I put these two, like the seeds of the apple, and that's why I did it in black. So that's just how I did the apple. Now I've got a little tag here that says "so proud of you," and I haven't really decided yet. I think I want to put it right there. And then I made this little pie. What I did was I just kind of drew a hump, like a big pile of a hump, and then kind of like a shape of a pie, put them together, and then I took Stampin' Up! Scalp Border Punch, and I punched a strip across here, and I ended up trimming it down to fit on there. I just used a stamp that I had for journaling, and I stamped that across there, cut out some triangles to put at the top, like the slits in the pie, and stuck one of my apples that I made on the side. And I'm going to put this right down here. I got them there, and that's pretty much my first page. So that's what the first one's going to look like. So then I've got my second one. So the first thing I'm going to do, again, is I'm going to put this strip across the front of it. Now, before I put the strip across there, I'm going to have to get my other one and kind of sit it over here. I'm going to kind of line this up. So that when they're side by side, the border just extends over all of that. Okay, so we'll move this one out of the way. So then on this one, I am going to take, and I've done the words pie. Let me find what I do with my P here. There is a P on my desk. It must have fallen off when I was moving everything. So I'm going to put a couple apples along here to kind of fill up that spot. Then I've got a pitcher that is going to go right here. And then I've got 3x3 pitchers that I've matted. And I'm going to put them along here, along the base of the card. Kind of like this. And then I'm going to stack like 3 little pie or apples right here in the middle. And I made this little rolling pin. I had one, I don't know from where, from many, many probably moons. And I kind of just shortened it down and put it in the color that I wanted. And I'm going to put this little rolling pin across there. And then I'm going to put this, it says Simply Adorable up there. And I'm going to add 3 little brads across the top of that. So I'm going to put this all together, and then I'm going to show you a finished product of it when it's all done. Okay, everybody, I'm back. And I just want to show you the finished product, and I'll get some pictures so you can see it better at the end. But this is just kind of a rundown of the 2 pages I journaled. And, you know, that's it. That's how I did it. I'm really glad I was doing this challenge, and that I've set this 13-week challenge for myself and maybe somebody else. And because of the weekend that I have had, we've had a great weekend. And just did a lot of stuff with our church and been very busy. Sarah had to go to camp this weekend and just been running. And to be honest with you, if I did not have this challenge, that this had to be done by Sunday so that I could post it Monday, I probably would not have done this. So I'm really proud that I had the challenge and that I just didn't, you know, give up and not do it. So, and I also wanted to let you know, these little, where it says Simply Adorable and So Proud of You, those are just some rub-ons that Stampin' Up! Used to sell. And I still had some left, so I wanted to use them up. So that's pretty much it. So thanks for stopping by, everybody. And if you haven't joined my challenge, there'll be posted some lucky winner at the end. And if you didn't join the last 2 weeks, please jump in and join me. It's always more fun when we have more people doing it together. Thanks for stopping by. Bye-bye.